board for a while, you're probably feeling pretty good about utilizing the basic features and functions of the board. This session is going to talk about a few more resources that you have to multitask, create more engaging lessons, as well as a couple tips and tricks that you may not be aware of. One thing that is used the most is our EasyWrite digital whiteboard. You probably use this on the fly every single day. This is where you have your main menu. This is where you have all of your pen resources. It's easy to quickly grab content directly from a Chrome browser, drop it in your whiteboard. But one thing that you may not know is that you can actually create your EasyWrite lessons ahead of time to open them on the board. You don't have to create everything while standing at the panel itself. You can download our EasyWrite 6 software directly from our website, but we also have the EasyWrite 6 app in the Play Store and the Apple Store as well. When you download that software, it will look exactly like this when you open it on your computer. You have mostly all of the same resources and tools to be able to embed all of your content, as well as create all of those manipulatives and those resources that you use every day. Once you've created one of those lessons, it's best if you drop it into your cloud drive. I can tap the three lines on the bottom left, tap the file folder, and now I can pull up all of my recent lessons that I've recently edited on the board, but I can tap the file folder again to be able to access my cloud drive. Now I can go into my Google Drive, into my drive, and I can now go pull that EasyWrite lesson that I created ahead of time. This is going to bring in all of the pages from that lesson. So now that activity that I want to use with my students, I don't have to spend time creating it at the panel. I've created it at home or during my planning time, or maybe this is a resource that's in your shared team drive, and now I can easily pull it up and access these resources from the board. So now I have my different manipulatives that I can now use with my students. You can also manage all of the pages within this lesson by tapping on the page numbers, and you can see how many different slides there are within the lesson. I can click and drag to reorder, or maybe I want to duplicate and I want to have multiple slides of the same thing. I can tap the three dots, tap the copy icon, and it's now going to duplicate that slide. So I have multiple copies of that activity. Another resource within EasyWrite that is great for student engagement is our collaborative option called Cloud Whiteboard. Cloud Whiteboard allows you to have a cloud whiteboard session, and it's just as it sounds. I can start a cloud whiteboard manually from the board, which is going to give a QR code that students can easily scan from their iPads or their Chromebooks, and it will prompt them to type in their name to join my lesson. Or if you have Google Classroom, you can start Google Classroom, and it will drop the link directly into your class. Now, when students click on the link, it takes them straight into your Google Classroom. The Cloud Whiteboard takes everything I'm doing in the EasyWrite whiteboard and it puts it on their student device. So you'll see here, if you have a student that isn't in your Google Classroom, they can easily scan this QR code, or you can drop this link with the session ID into your Schoology or Canvas account for students to easily access and join your Cloud Whiteboard. Once your Cloud Whiteboard session is live, you'll have an option down here at the bottom, the little person with three lines. This will show you all of your participants. You can see your whole class list. They've typed in their name. If you use Google Classroom, it will pre-populate the name that they've been given in their Google Classroom roster. And they default as view only. So their pencil next to their name is gray because right now all they can do is view what I'm doing in my EasyWrite. But when I tap on an icon and I move, click and drag and I move these resources, or if I make a note about something that's going on, what I am doing in live time is happening on their device. So even when I move into the next page and we work on an example, everything I'm doing will navigate on their computer. This is great not only for a collaborative option, but even just accessibility. Sometimes you have students that have to sit in the back of the room or they're off to the side and they can't see very well. You're now able to take your lesson from the front of the room and push it directly to their device. But maybe you want the students to collaborate with you. I can pick and choose who I want to have editing rights. As I mentioned before, it defaults them to view only, but I can tap on their little pencil and the pencil will turn blue. And now they have the option to edit this lesson. So if I allow one person to edit and they edit from their computer, it's going to edit on the board in live time along with everyone else in the classroom. This is a great option when you have students working in groups and maybe one person is going to be editing on the front of the room. And so everyone has an opportunity to see and learn from one another. An option that the students have when in Cloud Whiteboard is they have a little feature to raise their hand. So again, this is just a great option for some of those students who just don't feel comfortable raising their hand and asking a question out loud. You as the teacher can quickly see who has a question, or you can quickly take a poll as well. Whenever the students raise their hand, a little red bubble will appear right here with a total number of hands raised. So it's an easy way to say, raise your hand if you don't understand, or raise your hand if you've got it. And now you can quickly see how many students in your classroom are ready to move on to the next task. When you end your Cloud Whiteboard session, it will actually keep that session open in your students' browser, and they can continue editing on their own. This no longer is a live session, so what they edit on their screen is purely their copy now. It's not in live time for everyone else to see. So a great option here would be to have an independent practice piece at the end of the lesson, so that when you end your Cloud Whiteboard session, the students get to continue working on that independent practice, and then they can just drop it right back into your digital classroom so you can see if they've got it. Another tool that really comes in handy is the screen record option. You've probably seen you have the screen record option down at the bottom right. I tap the record and now it's recording everything I'm doing on the screen. So even when I'm navigating from slide to slide or going to different locations, or even if I go to my home screen, you'll see that the recording is still going. This is recording everything I'm doing on my screen, as well as recording my voice using the microphones on the front of the panel. I can quickly pause because maybe I need to navigate to another resource, but I don't need to waste the video time pulling something else up. I can quickly pause it and then I can hit play. And now I can save it to my cloud drive. So I can hit stop, give it a name, and then it's going to ask me where I want to save it. I can save it directly to the board. I can save it to my cloud drive. And now I can access that video in my cloud drive and drop it into my Google Classroom or my Schoology Classroom, whatever resource that you use. And so now all those students that need a reference video, or maybe it's a quick tutorial, or maybe students were absent and they missed a really important concept, you can now screen record everything that you're doing so they don't have to miss a thing. Another resource you're probably very familiar with is the casting tool. Using InstaShare 2 allows you to cast from your computer to the board using the InstaShare 2 app. You can download that software directly from our website, but the app also lives in the Play Store and the App Store. You open InstaShare 2 app on the board, and then you open the InstaShare 2 app on your computer, and you can type in the pairing code or select the board name. You can now mirror everything on your computer to the board, and you have full touchback. But one thing you can also do is send the board to your device. Too many times, we're stuck in one place in the classroom. You're either stuck at your computer or you're stuck at the board, but a lot of the learning happens by walking around and facilitating those incredible student conversations. So to be able to do that, you can utilize the InstaShare 2 app and send the board to your device. When you open your computer and open InstaShare and connect to the board, you're given a couple of options. One of those options is cast from the board to the device. The app looks like this. You can now see that I'm currently sharing my computer screen. So right now you're looking at my computer desktop. My other option is board to device. I can tap board to device, and now in my host menu, I can see one device is sending to the board, but I can also tell the board to send to a device as well. So I'm going to connect my tablet. I'm now sending the board to my tablet. Over here in my host control, I can see that my laptop is sending to the board. I can see that the board is sending to my tablet. There are two icons next to my name. I can select the finger one, that's gonna give me the full touchback, Or I can select, and I can select the notepad with the paper, which is going to give me the ability to annotate. Now, in the InstaShare 2 app on your computer or on your tablet, whichever device you're using, you'll have these matching icons that you have to toggle on your device as well. So I'm going to tap my touchback, and I can now control everything on the panel. So I'm actually going to step behind the camera, and you're going to watch the board. I can quickly go to my home screen. I can open EasyWrite. I can go back to my home screen. I can open Chrome. So I have lots of different options using my tablet from anywhere in the room. This does not take away the touchback that I have on the board. I can use my device or I can use the board. So I might be in the back of the classroom running the board, but students might be up navigating this resource. So you don't have to pick between one or the other. You can do both simultaneously. If I wanted to be able to annotate on the board, I can quickly use the annotation function so I can highlight something or circle something. But when I'm on the home screen, I do still have access to the floating tool. So I'm gonna go back to my home screen here. I can go back to my home screen and I still have the option to utilize the floating tool. So I have a couple different ways of annotating the resources on my device when using InstaShare 2. So no longer are the days where you have to stand at the board, at the whiteboard, stuck in one spot. You can now utilize that zone of proximity by standing right in between those students, facilitating those conversations from anywhere in the classroom. Sometimes you might want to have multiple resources and multiple apps open at the same time. One thing you're probably already familiar with is the fact that you can easily split your screen when you're in EasyWrite. I can utilize my toolbox and tap on Chrome, and it's going to auto split my screen. But maybe you want to have multiple apps open. You can actually have up to 6 apps open at the same time by utilizing our multi-window feature. The multi-window feature allows you to open an app, tap the sidebar, and tap multi-window. It's now going to take that resource that I'm in, it's going to put it in a smaller window. I can utilize the arrow icons to change the size to make it bigger or smaller. I can move this out of the way, and now I can go grab another resource. So maybe I want to have YouTube open at the same time. I can come into YouTube, I can grab a video. Again, I tap the side menu, put it in multi-window, I can make it smaller, and now I have my YouTube over here. Maybe I also want to have my EasyWrite open. I have my EasyWrite, I can put it in multi-window, change the size. All of these, I still have full touchback and full functionality within my multi-window, but I can just utilize the resources and have multiple things open at the same time. The black bar at the bottom is where you can click to drag to move it around, but you also have the split screen icons. So if you decide that you don't need to have 3 or 4 things open at one time, you just want to have 2 different apps open at the same time, maybe you want to have your Chrome browser open on one side, you can tap the left screen icon, and you want to have YouTube on the other, I can tap the right. So now I've got my YouTube and my Chrome browser in split screen mode. I can easily get those out of split screen mode or close out the app completely by utilizing the icons at the bottom. The arrows are going to take it back down to that small version, or I can completely close out of the app by using the X. If I want to go back full screen, I can tap the full screen icon as well, and now I'm back in my app utilizing the full screen. In addition to using multi-window to have multiple applications on the board open, you can also utilize multi-window with an input source as well. So for example, if I have Chrome open and I want to have multi-window between Chrome and my computer that's connected, I can take my Chrome, put it in multi-window, but then I can come over here and grab my input source. So right now I have my computer plugged in to the USB-C port. It's going to bring my computer up, but I don't need this in full screen. Again, I tap on the sidebar, tap multi-window, and now it's going to take that input source and it's going to make it a multi-window. So now I've got my Android open, I've got my Chrome open, and I have my input source as well. So if you have your computer hardwired, you can switch over between your sources and utilize multi-window as well. If you have any questions about any of the things that you saw in this recording today, be sure to jot them down now and bring them to our live Q&A webinar on September 9th. See you soon.